Hello, Assalamualaikum. How are you, children? I hope you are all happy, good, healthy. You're well. Okay, so do you recall that some time ago I had told you two background stories about two famous nursery rhymes? Now, nursery rhymes, these English nursery rhymes, you know, most of them are very popular, very famous. And children all around the world where English is spoken, they have grown up listening to them or reciting them, memorizing them. And so did I. And even at this age, I still remember those. Okay. So if you want to look at those videos again, you may of course do that. But today I'm going to tell you about another beloved nursery rhyme, and that is Humpty Dumpty. Yes, that big egg-like man who sat on a wall and he had a great fall and so on, and you know the rest, okay? So let's find out if Humpty Dumpty was actually an egg, or what was this story? All right, so before that, let me ask you one other question. How many of you know about Alice in Wonderland, that, you know, famous book? Have you read it? If you haven't, you must read it. You can't grow up without reading Alice in Wonderland. All right, so it was written by the famous English author. Did someone say Lewis Carroll? Yes, you did. Then you are right. Okay, so Lewis Carroll wrote Alice in Wonderland. But Lewis Carroll also wrote a similarly beloved novel, and that was called Through the Looking Glass. It was written, it was published in 1871. Yes. And I want to read a bit of it here from my computer. When the character of Alice meets the character of Humpty Dumpty. And that happens in the sixth chapter of the novel. And here's what happens. Okay, I'm reading from this. The egg only got larger and larger and more human. When she had come within a few yards of it, she saw that it had eyes and a nose and a mouth. And when she had come close to it, she saw clearly that it was Humpty Dumpty himself. "It can't be anybody else," she said to herself. "I'm as certain of it as if his name were written all over his face." Okay, so here is the character of Humpty Dumpty as we know it today, which is the egg-like character, right? But huge and bizarre egg sitting precariously on the wall and so on. I want to tell you that before this, before Lewis Carroll wrote this, a number of military historians, they say that Humpty Dumpty was the name that was given to a cannon. You know, a cannon, top, jo jangon mein istemal hoti hai. In wars, you use tanks and cannons and so on. So this particular cannon was used by the royalists in the English Civil War. Okay, and that conflict, it raged from 1642 to 1649. But in June of 1648, this big cannon, of course there were many other cannons as well, which these were placed on the walls of the Colchester, and Colchester is a town in England. And so Humpty Dumpty was placed there, but the parliamentary forces, they damaged the walls, of course, with their own artillery. They damaged the walls so badly that Humpty Dumpty fell. It came down, yes, and literally, I mean, it broke into pieces, and literally none of the king's men or the horses could, of course, do anything. They couldn't put it back again. And you know who the king was in those times? It was Charles I. And so the royalists, the cavaliers of the king, couldn't do anything. They lost the fight, and King's Charles also lost his head. Yes. So, much like the other nursery rhymes that have these dark stories behind them, this one, Humpty Dumpty, was also about this cannon. So anyway, the point is that nothing wrong in learning the nursery rhymes, it's interesting. It's just interesting to learn also about the backstories, what created them, because it's always, I find it very, for my own interest, I feel that one should know what inspires writers, you know, what are the characters or something that stimulates them into writing. Imagine that for years and years these nursery rhymes have been going around, and they are memorized by children and for generations. So one more to add to your list, and maybe some other day I will tell you something about some other nursery rhyme. All right, until then, Khuda Hafiz, but I'll see you tomorrow again, maybe with a story, maybe with something else. So keep watching. Khuda Hafiz.